The Week in Review with David Davis. Welcome to this week's Week in Review. Everybody knows there are problems up and down the country with illegal immigration. Illegal immigrants being housed in hotels and various other facilities in pretty much every constituency in Britain. I found out that the Home Office is going to double the number of people it's put in a single hotel in my constituency. Now, all right, that may be necessary. Everybody's got to take a share of the burden. But if they're doing that, they've got to plan out what they do about social support, what they do about GP support, you know, what these typically young men in this case are going to, what pressure they're going to put on the community and how we abate that, how we stop local people suffering from this. And when I tried to get an answer out of the Home Office, they said, oh, we'll tell you in a week, which is bluntly not good enough. You tell us before you do it. And I raised that matter in the House of Commons because I was concerned that my constituents weren't getting the right service. And interestingly, listen to the end, when the Speaker also points out that she has had, or Deputy Speaker, has had similar problems. And I think that implies most of the House is having those problems.
Mr. David Davis.
Thank you, Madam Deputy Speaker. I apologise for raising yet again a question of accountability of the Home Office. Like many colleagues, I have two locations in my constituency which have 100 or so illegal migrants in them, and so be it. We all have to carry our burden. But we've just heard that one of them is going to be doubled in size. When I attempted to find out from the Home Office what was planned, they told me they couldn't let me know for a week. And when we went back and said that wasn't good enough, they said, well, we'll let you know as soon as possible, but it will be days. Can you give me guidance as to what we can do to accelerate the response of the Home Office when they're doing their job?
I thank the Right Honourable Gentleman for his point of order. I find myself in precisely the same position as a constituency MP as he does, almost exactly as he has just related. And I wish I had an answer to his question which I could give him from the chair, but I don't. But I will say to him that he's raised a very important point. I fully appreciate it, as do my constituents, and I will endeavour to find an answer for him.
A couple of weeks ago, we talked about the whole issue of housing. We had an incredible debate, very expert debate. I was talking about garden villages and towns. Others, people who have been heads of council planning committees, people who have been professionals in the business of designing, building, planning for houses, all that sort of area. Now, the House of Commons at its best. Lots of good ideas. The reason I promoted that debate, because I asked for the debate from a relevant committee, the reason I promoted it, because I thought this is going to be a subject which is going to go further and further and further up the public's priorities. Well, we saw that this week with Keir Starmer use all of his questions to talk about housing or to challenge the Prime Minister on housing, and you got the response that you will see here.
Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, the Honourable Gentleman now claims that he supports house building, especially on the Green Belt. But unfortunately for him, it's good that he agrees that he does believe that now, but unfortunately for him, the Shadow Deputy Prime Minister, the Shadow Minister for Women, the Shadow Health, Justice, Defence, Business, Northern Ireland and Scotland Ministers are all united against more house building in their areas, Mr. Speaker. I would say to them, though, they don't have to worry too much because he's never actually kept a promise he's made.
It's almost a tradition now that we talk about artificial intelligence. It's become incredibly topical since we started talking about it many months ago. And there are a couple of big things now which are actually good uses of artificial intelligence without any of the risks that we have been hearing about from some of the leaders in AI research in the last few weeks. The first is that the very first drug designed by an artificial intelligence is going through the process of approval. It's an important drug. It's designed to deal with certain specific lung complaints. and pretty much all the stages, at all stages, were designed by an artificial intelligence. And we'll see how successful it is at the end of the approval process and when it's put into effect. The other artificial intelligence issue that is topical this week is relates to the NHS, where in Cambridge they are starting to use it to screen to enable doctors to map out the where in the body radiotherapy will be focused. So if you've got a cancer, there'll be elements where you want to focus radiotherapy. The more accurately you do that, the more precisely you do that, the more successful you are in getting rid of the cancer, and also the fewer side effects, because you're not irradiating bits of the body that don't need to be irradiated. We're told this is 90% effective, which is at least as good as humans mapping out these areas. So again, a very useful and effective application of AI in medicine. We've been talking for some time as well about carbon capture, principally because I thought it would become more and more important in meeting net zero targets, meeting environmental targets. And this week in the news, there's discussion of capturing carbon dioxide from the air and from industrial exhaust and so on, and applying it to make fuel, syngas, combining it with hydrogen and other such things. And this is, in my view, one of the very important threads of research, which will do two things. It'll take carbon dioxide out of the air, and it will supplant other sources of petroleum-style materials for fuels in cars or whatever it might be. So again, a very important application of carbon capture. And the story of carbon capture is simple. If we are going to achieve any of our environmental targets, carbon capture is one of the things that's going to be absolutely essential. And this is one step along the way. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click thumbs up. Subscribe if you want to. Tell your friends about it. We continue every week. I mean, some of the things recur, but generally trying to be topical about what's going on in the Commons, what's going on in society at large with importance for our future.